Jesus anyway.
Hallelujah,
somebody
hallelujah.
Say, great and mighty is
God bless you for going back and being back with us. And I'm actually 11:45 morning worship service. This is the day that we have our studio time that we bring the world to millions, some thousands throughout all the world. And it's just a pleasure for you guys to come and be with me in the studio. If you ever get a chance to want to drop by and be with us on one of our recorded services, you can do so. You just got to go to my website, or you can reach me by email. It's called harvesthnlc@gmail.com. Or you can call me at 214-870-2146. That'll get you in contact with me personally for those who are actually calling in to be a part of what we're doing here at Harvest United Church. But we're going to not delay the time. We're going to move forward. Right, the music, as I say all the time, move forward and kind of get the atmosphere conditioned. You know, nothing can never happen with the power of God. Can you condition the atmosphere and allow the word to go forth? You know, the Bible declares the word is not complete. The service is not complete, excuse me, until the word actually goes forth. So we want to get some clarity, understanding. We want to bring the word and scripture to you in accuracy. We want to make you hear clearly about what those scriptures are saying and speaking of as you follow along with your word, and get some accuracy concerning that what God has given us has come from the kingdom. I think it's so important that we as men and women of God get an accurate understanding and knowledge of the educational part of the scriptures, as well as the revelation of what God is speaking. So that demands us to bring it to you clearly, without error, and make sure that we're going to give you what you need to hear in the season which you're in, that you may go forth. I believe instructions, when they're given to you, they come plain. We talked about this morning in the book of Habakkuk, you know, make it plain. Write the scriptures up on the tables, and make it clear for all to see. So we want to make sure we get all the information to you clearly. We're going to be right back with you. We're going to open up a prayer, and we're going to get started here as we go forth with the word of God this morning. God bless.
Since the day that Adam fell, sin is where it started, sin is why it held. Speaking as a prisoner who was there and lived to tell, I remember how it felt. I could hear the sound of freedom like a distant voice had called and beckoned me to follow where I had never gone. Though my heart was willing, I just stood there at the wall, praying somehow it would fall. But in a cross I found the doorway, and the hand that held the keys. When the chains fell at my feet, for the first time I could see. This is how it feels to be free. This is what it means to know. Prison I was in, like a living nightmare, burning deep within. I can feel the voice of evil, I can hear the call of sin, but I won't go back again. You see, once I tasted freedom, and the chains could bind no more, mercy gave me wings to fly, like an eagle I can soar.
before your throne, Father God, bringing forth the word that comes from the kingdom of God. Lord, I declare right now, even as I speak, Father God, you anoint this word. Father God, bring the word with clarity, with wisdom, understanding, direction. As the word of God decreed that, as a book says in the book of two, to write it plain. Let me speak plain. Let it write upon the tables of the hearts of your people, that they may understand and realize that they get perfect directions in what you want them to do in the season which they're in. Father God, we decree the word right now in the name of Jesus. And we ask you, Father God, to continue to look over it, Father God, even as we go forth and continue to do that which you have called us to do. Father God, I thank you for this opportunity. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray, Lord, amen. It's always good for the opportunity for you guys to be with us here at Harvest New Life Church and Harvest New Life Studios here in the city of Dallas. I'm going to be going over to the book of 1 Corinthians over in chapter 12. We're going to talk about some of the spiritual things that took place in the book of Corinth concerning some of the issues that was going on in Corinth with some of the people who are alleging to be something that Christ told them not to be. We're going to continue to just go forth, and we're going to hear what the Word of God has to say in this season, because I believe it is a season. Clear my voice here. It is a season that we're in, and we want to make sure we get clear understanding about what God is speaking to us concerning this word that we're about to give to you. We're going to be in the book of Corinthians. I want to make sure we get good clarity and understanding of what we're speaking about today. I want to make sure we got all things in the background cleared out. Got, of course, Co-Pastor Patty Ellis is joining us here in the studio. And we want to make sure that Christ is doing what he said he's going to do concerning the word of God. Just making sure, you know, I don't get clogged up here. And of course, at the time, they're having little issues with some of the sinuses here a little bit, but I'm going to believe God and declare that he's got a perfect word that's coming forth today. Let's turn our Bibles, as I said before, for those who actually want to join us on the show here at our Spreaker.com. Now, we're broadcasting at one time. This is a pretty powerful system. We're broadcasting at this time over about 12, I'm going to say about 20 different social networks. You can catch us on some of those social networks. Pretty much every one of them, just about. We're actually making waves out. We're not only here in the States. We're all over the world. And for those who have opportunity to want to hear us, you can go to your iPhones, iPads, whatever you may have. And all you have to do is simply go to your app store, whatever it may be, and just put in the app, which is Spreaker, S-P-R-E-A-K-E-R. That's the hub that we're coming out of here at Harvest New Life Church and Harvest New Life Studios. Even though, of course, our physical services, that's the very thing we come out of also when you hear us actually speaking in our actual physical services as well. And when you get to that particular app, you want to go to the search bar and you want to put in Charles Ellis. Now, it's going to be several shows. I say it all the time. It's going to be there. But you want to choose the show that me and my little daughter are actually in Carolina blue shirts. I'm carrying her on the top of my shoulders, as I always do, and is having fun with her. So that's going to get you into the show as of right now as we're speaking. As we go to the book of Corinthians, we make our way over to that particular chapter, and we talk about Corinth. It was Corinth is more or less like a like Dallas, you know, any city that you live in. It's more like a metropolitan city, full of a lot of things that's going on in the city. You know, we talk about all the different ministries, different churches, different way of speaking the word, bringing forth the word, and how men have certain giftings and endowments that Christ has given them to be able to bring forth the word to the people, you know, spiritual discernment. And but it all speaks about the process of how it's all through one spirit. You know, and the Word of God makes it very clear to the Corinthians. And they were the people that's really kind of come from a pagan background. They had a lot of different unease about things that was going on in their life. I don't think they even knew who they were, you know, talking about some of the processes they had to go through. Because, you know, when we're back in the book of Corinthians 3, we talk about how Paul and Apollo got into a dispute. And God began to warn and tell them that, who are you? I mean, who are either one of you that you could do anything? So it's not about what you see in terms of a pastor preaching or teaching or doing anything. Let me say something before we get started here. When you talk about the Word of God, you talk about the precious power of the Spirit, you know, there's a lot of things that's going on in the earth realm. And I tell you, that's things that we're dealing with that even politicians don't have the ability to be able to solve what's going on. But God is telling that when you understand that moving into the earth realm and moving in the Spirit of God, you know, God says he does nothing unless it's revealed through the Spirit. He talks about it in the book of Amos, and he talks about how God said he doesn't bring a word into the land unless it's revealed through the prophet. And the Word of God declares right here as we begin to speak about some of the activities that we saw that was going on in various times and various ways that we see right now, how God prepares the people in the process of getting them to understand. When you're living as of we're doing right now in what we call dangerous times, threatened by different conditions, these are things that politicians cannot handle. It can handle. The battle of forces in every country that we're dealing with are spiritual. These situations only come to when we begin to rise up and actually come together, and not just come together. We would like for you to come together to be us one. But as I said in chapter 3, verse 1 Corinthians, they talk about the division that was going on in Corinth. And even so now, you know, there's a lot of diversities, a lot of conditions, a lot of things that's going on in the land. And if we don't rise up and come into an intercessional prayer to be as one, as the Word of God declares according to Psalms 133, how good is a man to dwell together in unity. Unity brings forth power. It brings forth deliverance. It brings forth the wisdom of God. And that when we all as one, we come together and we'll get the understanding and discernment that God has in store. In other words, when we begin to intercede for God and intercede and having a prayer to know that we come together in a session of prayer. See, individual prayer is only for you and your relationship with Christ. But when you begin to intercede with God, intercession is the vehicle that goes into the kingdom of God, get what you need, and brings it back into the earth realm, that it display the power of what God has given us as being men and women of God. God doesn't want us to be ignorant of our spiritual giftings. Know that God gave us the power to tread, as it says in Luke 10:19, upon every serpent and every scorpion and every power of the enemy. It declares the decrees according to Ephesians 1:21. It says that far above every prince and every power in dominion, not only named in this world, but everything's to come. When we understand and realize the process of how God gave us the dominion, he gave us authority. Then we talk about Jacob and the process of the angel. The reason Jacob had the authority over the angel when he said, I will not let you go until you bless me. Because the angel was out of his jurisdiction. He was in a realm that's always been given to Jacob in the process of holding the angel there, in the process of not letting him go until he blessed him. And the angel touched him on his hip. You can see about the separations of the hip. And he began to go back. And as he began to release Jacob in that period of time, they talked about the process. You know, my hip has been disjointed. Now God declares that the angel is now being released to go back to his realm. What are you saying, Pastor Ellis? What are you saying? Let's make it very clear. The only way you can operate in your gifting is what God has given you, according to the word, according to the power, according to the purpose, according to the spirit. When you got a team, you got a CEO, you got people that's actually in your environment of doing the word of God, working with the word of God, and they understand what they got to know where their position is. You got different ranks and different categories or different areas or different teams, whatever it may be, first team, second team, third team. The battle is based on what team you put first. Now, in the sense of being in the area of Christ, it's the spirit. It's all the self-same spirit. There's no big I's, no big U's. There is no competition. As a matter of fact, in the body of Christ, there is too much competition. Because we don't come together and be as one. We have come to a point now that we look upon one man as being greater than the other man. And God said, my gifts are no greater than any other man. But even though I gave one man authority here, even talk about the talents. All the talents, whether 5 talents, whether 2 talents, whether 3 talents, all the giftings work.